Welcome back to my channel. So today I've prepared a makeup tutorial for beginners. If you've been following my Instagram or any of social media, you'll know that I've been to Bali recently and then to Europe, to Copenhagen and to London for pleasure and business trip. I've been really busy and just skipping, you know, makeup because I simply didn't have time. And then now that I'm trying to, you know, like get back to the routine, I realized that it's pretty difficult because I guess there has been some gap. And so that inspired me to do a makeup for beginners. If you're a newbie to makeup, then please keep on watching. First off is base makeup. And I remember when I used to do my makeup for the first time, I skipped primer of any kind because, you know, I mean, probably the less is better, and also you don't really know about different products, so you might not even know what primer is. So I think what's best is just go straight into foundation or BB cream, whatever you use. And I think that it should be easy to use something like this, a cushion foundation, liquid foundation, or like stick foundation or whatever. It's harder to use because it's harder, I guess, to blend out. I mean, you need maybe more skill, I guess, probably. So I'm just going to use cushion foundation, which happens to be a very popular means of base makeup in Korea. And so this one is a little different from what I am used to. So they have these like holes on the bottom, and then you just press on it to get some like products in here. So it's very, I guess, it saves the products, and then it's not going to dry out the product when you're using it. It's not rocket science, you just need to dab it on to your face. One thing that a lot of newbies forget, and I think is extremely important, is to make sure that the boundaries between your neck and your face is blurred out or blended out, so it doesn't look like you have a floating white face, right? The more times that you dab on with the cushion, it's just going to give you more even and, I guess, thin layer of foundation so that you look more natural. So we're done with the base makeup. That was super easy. If you like dewy look, then cushion foundation tend to be very dewy, so this is the ideal look. If you prefer matte finish, then you can always go in with powder. As a newbie, I think it's always better to just go with the makeup tool that you're given with the product. So for this powder as well, I'm just going to use the puff that comes with the product. You don't really know what's good, and even if you have good tools, you don't really know how to use it. So I think you don't really need to invest at that time. I used to have glow on the cheek before when I used the dewy foundation, but now it's very matte. Next is eyebrow makeup, and eyebrows are extremely important. It frames the face, it frames the image of your makeup. Angle brush like this one is easier to draw. It has this angle so that you can make the arch a lot easier. It's easier to use powder or gel eyeliner to work step by step and with less pigment. I truly believe that it's easiest to use the beauty tool that comes with the product, but for eyeshadow, I think for newbies, it's always easiest to use your fingers. It's not something of an intense color, so it's easier to work with even if you make mistakes. Take on the same base color to the front bottom end to really open it up. Make a semicircle towards the end. Use the same skinny brush to take darker color, and then just apply like a thin line, this dark brownish or in burgundy color. Using this angled brush, make a wing at the end of the eyes like so, and then just blend out. The area that I'm applying it is a lot smaller and skinnier. Voila! Extend the end of your eye like so, but then put it upward a little. I find the pencil eyeliner is easiest to work with. Just fill that in, bring it up to the top. I'll show you how to fix this in a second. This is an eraser pen that I like to use. After cleaning up, apply again a layer of eyeshadow that's now been removed. Now that I'm done with the eye makeup, I'm just going to wait for a while before I go in with curler or mascara, because sometimes, especially the eyeliner, it needs time to really like settle down and then to harden. So if you go in right away with curler or mascara, it tends to take away the product, so you might ruin it, or worst case is that you are going to take that product from your eyelids to like under the eyes. You're going to make a mess of the base makeup, which is always bad. And so back to the base makeup and do my blush. I'm going to use cream texture because it's just easiest to use your finger for. Just below the highest point of your cheeks. Here. I just made like a heart shape. So easy, right? Before the cream gets hardened, I'm just going to blend it out like so. Let's go back to the eyes. This lever that you put pressure on, it's a lot wider, so it's easier for you to work with. Mascara with a thin brush like this is easier to work with than fatter one that gives you more volume, because the thicker and the curvy it is, it's going to make it harder to go in accurately, and it's going to leave like stains around your eyelashes. Heat of the finger is going to make the lashes stay up a little longer. The final step is the lips, and it's honestly the easiest. You don't have to do full lips because it's harder to make the line perfect. So what we are going to do is more of tinted water paint effect of lips. So I'm going to take a lip gloss or like lip tint, apply it in the center of the lips. As a beginner of makeup, fingertips is the best makeup tool that you have. Voila! So finally, we finished the makeup, and this is the result. Colors are pretty subtle, and there's nothing really dramatic, so that it's really suitable for everyday simple makeup. And as you see, it just brightens up your look, and it just defines everything. Let me know, guys, what other great tips you have. And as always, don't forget to subscribe. You can just click that subscribe button here. Check out my other videos on makeup tutorials and makeup products review, and come visit my Instagram. It's open for all of you. And thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!